Have you ever spent an entire Saturday afternoon trying to master Notion only to have more tabs open on your computer than you have friends on social media? I get it. I've been on this journey for the last couple of months trying to get my life and business streamlined and organized to make me more effective. And I have spent hours and hours trying all of the different apps out there, but nothing really seemed to do exactly what I was looking for. Now, I wanted a system that allowed me to search for my notes when I actually needed to reference them, created a way for me to write out and organize my YouTube scripts and my content inside of systems so I could easily share it with my team instead of having a million Google Docs out there, a project management system that allowed me to assign tasks to myself and to my team to make sure that everything got done and that nothing fell through the cracks without having to switch between multiple different apps for notes and then for project management and for content creation. And then finally, a system that allowed me to see all of these tasks on a calendar view so that I was able to map out all my launches, all my content, all my tasks, all in one place. Not too much to ask for, right? Now, originally, this led me down the path to Notion because it promised all of these things, and it was marketed as a super customizable way to assign tasks, create a calendar for yourself, write all your notes inside of, but I found it super confusing to set up, and this just led me into a dark hole of Google and many tabs open and many, many hours wasted trying to set it up. If you have been in the same boat with Notion, let me know in the comments below. But eventually, after many, many hours and late nights trying to set up this Notion system for myself, I honestly just gave up and went back to my tried and true Asana. But the thing is that as much as I love Asana, it still didn't have a way for me to organize all of my notes in one place and have a way for me to reference those notes whenever I needed them. And this was crucial for me because I was wasting so much time flipping through old notebooks, trying to reference notes from past conferences or things that my coaches had told me or programs that I had taken. And I really wanted a way for me to bring up that information quickly all in one place. So when xTiles reached out to me about their software, I was instantly intrigued. At first glance, it seemed like exactly what I was looking for, and after spending some time inside of the system, I realized that I was right. It's the perfect blend of digital bullet journaling and productivity apps designed for people with ADHD, entrepreneurs, and creatives. The amount of flexibility within this app is absolutely insane. If anyone is like me and is a big scrapbooker or loves a beautiful, pretty, color-coded notebook, then you're gonna love xTiles. Think of it like a blank piece of paper or a blank bullet journal where you can create tiles that are customized and move them around to make the actual blank page whatever you want it to be. And what I love so much about it is that it combines that with productivity tools to allow you to organize your tasks and create a calendar for yourself as well. So this allows me to have all of my productivity in one place so I can get rid of multiple tools and switching between multiple tools like Google Drive and then Asana and then Evernote and then Miro, like all the places that I was switching. I don't have to do that anymore because all of the things are in one place. So let's jump over into my computer so I can walk you through exactly what xTiles looks like and how I've customized it for myself.
Okay, so it's super easy to get started within xTiles. And so I'm gonna first show you what a new project looks like from scratch. And then I'm gonna dive into a couple different use cases of how I've actually used xTiles or started to play around with using it inside of my business. Okay, so when you're first looking to create a new project, there are a couple of things you want to take note of when you're first opening up this platform. So the first thing is spaces. So you can have your workspace, so what's called my workspace, and then you can create additional workspaces as well. So this is really great if you wanted to create a workspace for your business and then you wanted to have a personal workspace for maybe more personal things. You can actually separate things out based on department or based on your business, however you want to organize things. So I actually have a Wandermint creative space, which is my business, where I can invite team members and people can have access to different templates that I want to build out in the future. And then I also have my workspace, which is where I'm just building things out right now until I really get a hang of exactly how I want all of my workflows to work inside of xTiles. So that's the first thing to take note of is spaces. Then from there, the next level of organization is actually projects. So if you come up to the right-hand side here where it says new project, you can either start from scratch or use a template or import something from Markdown. But I don't want you to worry about that for now. I want you to just start from scratch so I can show you the different elements inside of xTiles here. So when you first start a new project, there are going to be these little pages or tabs along the top. And I want you to think about that like a Google Sheets, okay? So when you open a Google Sheet, you're going to see all the tabs at the bottom that allow you to create new pages. It's exactly the same within xTiles. And I love this because it allows you to have multiple pieces of information all within one project. So I want you to think about it like a binder in high school, okay? So you would have a binder for social studies, and then you would have a binder for math, and then a binder for English. And then inside of each binder, you would have different topics or different curriculum pieces that you would break down from there. And so I want you to think about your project instead of xTiles the exact same way. So your project is your binder, and then each of these tabs can be a different note or a different section that you need to keep organized within that binder, okay? So first things first, let's start with this first tab or this first page and show you all the different things you can do with it. First thing is you can make this full width if you want. And so now it's really a blank canvas for you to play with. And this really does just look like a bullet journal, right? Like if you got a physical bullet journal that you could just draw on and create boxes on and scribble on, that's exactly the same as this. This is just a digital format of that. And so within each page, you can create tiles, and that's why it's called xTiles, right? So you can drag and drop as many different tiles as you want, and you can totally customize them. You can make them as big as you want. You can drag them around. So if you wanted this one to go down there, you can really play around with what you want this to look like and make this super customized to you. Now, once you actually have created a tile, each tile itself is completely customizable. So if you come up to the top here where this little tile style, little paintbrush is, you could click on that and change. You can add an emoji here. You can add an emoji to the other side. You can add it to the left-hand side. You can make the text bigger or smaller. You can actually change the different colors within here. So maybe I want to have that there. Then you can add a different title. So I'm gonna say test title here. And then down here where it says click to add block, you can see all of the different options that you can put within the tile. And if you've used Notion before, this is going to look super familiar to you because it's very similar. You can add as many of these elements as you want within each tile. So for example, let's say that I wanted to create just some text. I'm going to say text here, and I'm going to say, this is how you use xTiles. You add note. Okay. So maybe I want to say test thoughts tile. Okay. This is maybe where you want to keep different notes that you have throughout the day. Maybe over here, you want to actually add an image because you want something to be really inspiring throughout the day. So you can just type in whatever you want here into Unsplash and it'll pick different pictures for you, or you can actually upload your own file, which would be really cool if you want to create a branding guide for yourself, or maybe a mood board or an inspiration board. You could do all of that within xTiles. But I'm just gonna click this one here. And there we go. Now I can drag this up to match the title size. And perfect. Now I have a little bit of an inspirational image for me to look at every single day. Now maybe I want to move this guy over here and I want to add some tasks. So then I could say, get computer fixed. Maybe that's a task I need to get completed. And maybe another task is get my hair done. Okay. Maybe this is like a personal board, and then you can attach different dates to it. So maybe I want that to be October 10th, and maybe this one's October 18th. So that's how you kind of can play around and customize a page within xTiles. And you can come up here and you can name this page, right? So maybe I want to rename it to personal ideas. Okay. You could also customize the board itself. So if you come up to the top here, you can actually pick the different icon at the top, and then I can say personal. Maybe I want to call this Melissa's personal inspiration board or something like that. And then you can also customize the cover at the top here. So you can go change cover. And again, you can use Unsplash or upload. And I'm just going to say, I'm going to put pink in here and find something really girly. Perfect. Maybe I like these clouds. I can add that in there. And then you can also reposition this however you want. So let's say that this is what I want to have happen, and I want to add some more tabs or more pages to this board. What I could do is just hit this add a page, and there is a bunch of different options for me to do so. So I can add a new creative page, which is what this page is here. And there are a bunch of templates that you can actually get started with really quickly. Or you can create a new document, which is going to look more like a Google document. Or if I hit new again, You can also pick a gallery, a board view, a calendar view, a table, or a timeline. So just to give you a quick example of what that might look like, you could come into calendar and let's pick one of these templates so you can see. Maybe I pick academic calendar. So in here, it's going to actually pull in a template for you to get started. And so you're gonna see all of the different information on here. And what's cool is it actually pulled in the tasks that I had from my personal ideas over here onto this academic calendar here. And obviously I could change the name of this. So I could say like personal calendar or whatever I wanted to have it here. But any of the tasks that I have within this board will also get put on this calendar view, which is really, really cool. The last feature that I really wanted to show you is databases. So you can create a database inside of anything. So if I created a new tile here, I could create a database in here and go up to a table. Or I could actually come over here and say new page and then table this way. But I want to just show you the different elements that a table can have. And tables are very similar to databases within Notion, if you're familiar with Notion. So I'm just going to drag this over here and just show you how you could use this. So let's say I wanted to create a database that had the different books that I want to read throughout the next year. Okay, so I want to say book name, maybe, and then I want to say author. And then maybe here I want to say, has it been read? And then I can also change the type here. So the other two were just text boxes, but maybe here I wanna say it's a checkbox. And then I wanna say date completed, okay? Maybe I want to see how long it takes me to read books or when I actually complete these books. So I can come in here and change this to date. Perfect, now I can come in and organize all of this information. So I can say, I could add in all my different books, all the different authors, and check off if I've read it or not and the date that I completed it. So that's just one example of how you could use a database. Obviously you can like play around and fill all this information into your heart's desire because it's super, super flexible and you really can do whatever you want within these different pages and these different tiles. But one of the biggest ways that I plan on using xTiles is for my business and for organizing my social media content calendar, because it's always been such a sticking point for me to find something that really does everything that I'm looking for. So I'm just gonna jump back over to my homepage here and go into my content planner that I have started to build out in xTiles. Now this process has not been 100% completed yet, but I wanna share my journey of what I have created so far. So the first thing that I have created is this weekly calendar. And so inside of here, I have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday built out for the week because I don't really post too much on the weekends. I like to keep it just in the week. And so the idea here is that anytime I have an inspiring thought or a content idea, I can come in here and add that in. And then for every single day of the week, I can come here every single Sunday and say, okay, for Monday, I want to post. Maybe I want to post a trending sound video. Maybe on Tuesday, I want to do a carousel post, right? And then on Wednesday, maybe I want to do a talking head video, right? So I can kind of start to map out what my content is going to look like. And then I can attach any to-dos that need to happen to get that piece of content done. So you're gonna see on Thursday here, I have find trending sound with a due date. So maybe here I say a task is to write out the script, right? And then I can actually attach a date to it as well. So this is kind of how I've been using it week by week to just plan out every week at a time. So I sit down on a Sunday and I kind of start to map this out with my to-dos. And you can also start to plan this ahead of time. So if you wanted to duplicate this, you could just come up to the top and hit duplicate and say, I don't want to duplicate with the data. I'm going to say duplicate. And then maybe here I say October 25th, and that's the week that I'm working on here. Now, one thing that could happen is that once you start doing this for every single week, it could start getting really messy with all of these different tabs at the top, right? So one really cool feature that I like about xTiles is you can actually come into it here and click on these three dots and say add to new group. And then you can say the new group is weekly calendar, okay? So now if I come back over to the first weekly calendar I created and say rename, I could rename this as October 18th, right? And then grab the three dots, say add page to group and go weekly calendar. And now it's all grouped under one page and is I duplicate this over and over again, I can just continue to stack them on top of each other for each week, which is really, really cool. So that's the weekly calendar view that I've been playing around with. And then the other view that I have is the social media calendar. And so this is really neat because it allows me to see everything at a really bird's eye view. And so what I have set up here is I have a calendar view, which is going to show you the different content on each day. And then I also have it by status. So what's in draft, planned, or posted. And then I also have all of the posts, posts by board. So this is more like a Kanban style where you can see which platform each of the pieces of content are going out on. And then I also have it filtered by YouTube videos. So this is going to show me only the YouTube content that I have planned. And so how you do this is by just creating a new calendar, and you could just create it just like that, just like I showed you when we were doing it from scratch. And then from here, to create all these different views, you would just come down to the bottom here and say add a new view and filter what specific thing you want filtered out to be able to see. So if I come back over into the all posts section and I open this one that I have, this test, you're going to see that you can also customize properties within the database itself. So on here, I have all these different properties added to help me stay really organized when it comes to content creation. So this is something I've been looking for in a project management tool for a really long time. So this allows me to completely customize what information I want on each of these cards. So here I have the time, the date, the status, so I can say whether it's planned or not, the type of content. So is it a story, a post, or a video? Who's responsible for it? I can add any keywords in here. I can add my content pillar. I can also add if a visual needs to get created for it or not, what platforms it needs to go on, and then I can also add any material or like graphics or video files that need to be added into here. And then at the bottom here, you can really, again, just start to customize this as much as you want. So you could come in here and add your caption in here. You could add your script if you wanted to write that out. All of the different things are possible within this tile. The other thing I really love about xTiles is the task management feature. So I showed you over here on the weekly calendar portion how I had added these different tasks into the different days that they need to get done. And so what's really cool about xTiles is it actually combines all of your tasks into one central place. So if you have tasks on this content planner board, and then maybe you have a different client board where you have tasks, and then maybe you have a team board where you have tasks, what it does is it compiles it all into this little inbox here, or this little task section here. So when I click on it, it's going to show me all the different tasks that I have assigned throughout all of my boards, which is really cool. You don't have to switch between every single board to find your tasks. Everything gets placed in this one central spot, and you can also view it on your calendar as well. So I really, really, really like this feature. And you can also sync your Google Calendar to this as well, so that it shows up on your Google Calendar as well. I don't personally have that. I like to keep them separate, but it is a really cool feature that allows you to sync the two. Okay, finally, the last thing that I want to show you is all of the templates that are inside of xTiles, because I know sometimes when you're trying to figure out a new tool, it can be kind of overwhelming, and sometimes you just want a jumping off point. So what's really neat is they have a bunch of templates included for free inside the platform. So if I just say plus here and I go to template gallery, you're going to see all of the different options that are available. So you can actually sort by the different sections here. So if you wanted personal life stuff, you could have a trip planner, you could have a reading list, a to-do list, a daily planner, or if you go into like agency or team, there is a video production agency, a social media agency, an event agency, or if you're looking for work, there's like notes, there's buyer personas, project overview. So you can really play around and use this as a jumping off point to get your feet wet within this platform.
All right, so no matter if you are using this for your personal life or for your business life, the amount of customization in this app is absolutely incredible, and I cannot wait to continue to dive in and create more systems within xTiles to help my productivity. As I'm building out more and more systems inside this app, I'd love to know what process or system you'd like to see next. So let me know in the comments below. And if you want to get started with xTiles for yourself, make sure to grab your account by clicking the link in the description below this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, make sure to hit that like button, share it on social media, and subscribe for more videos just like this.